Hi class, we start today discussing the geopolitical configuration of the world before the 1600 CE. The Indian Ocean was the center of the Afro-Eurasian trade world, a space that allowed the cultural, commercial, social and political contact between China, India, the Middle East, Africa and Europe. The volume of this trade was huge and increased continuously from the 7th until the 14th century. Usually, merchants interact with each other in multicultural and cosmopolitan port cities, some of which were rich and powerful. Most of these cities had some form of autonomous self-government and common interest, like controlling violence and attempts to monopolize trade. The most developed area was the South China Sea, and one good example of a famous port city was Malacca, which was part of a local sultanate conquered by the Portuguese in 1511. Today, the town is part of Malaysia. Malacca was a trading center in which goods were cheap for storage and redistribution. Among the many things exchanged in the ports were spices like pepper, cloves, nutmeg and sugar, textiles, porcelain, ivory and gold, which circulated between Asia and the Middle East, India and Africa. In general, this was a vast market that moved thousands of ships and a lot of money. By the year 1500, Arabs, Persians, Turkish, Indian, African and Chinese controlled this market, and the Western Europeans only play a minor role. Europe was in fact at the periphery of the world's economy and political powers. China was also the leader in sea exploration. The fleet of Admiral Zheng He was the most powerful on the planet, with hundreds of ships and thousands of men. It was only after China turned away from external trade that the Europeans had the opportunity to grow commercially. Another important center of trade and commerce in the area was India. The subcontinent had a privileged geographical position and was the link between the Persian Gulf and Asia. Arab merchants controlled trade on the coast of India because they were the first who circumnavigated the subcontinent. The commercial networks in this area were closely tied with religion and expanded together. Remember, for example, that despite having its origins in India, Buddhism is a philosophical tradition more popular in Asia. In the world system that existed at the time, India was a significant contributor by exporting goods such as pepper, cotton, and silk. In general, the people living around the Indian Ocean were very diverse in terms of language, religion, and culture. The region also had many things in common, like being sparsely populated. Most people lived in port cities or close to rice cultivation areas. One big difference between the Indian Ocean and other parts of the world was that women had a higher status in the region because their role in planting and harvesting rice gave them authority and economic power. Women participated in business as partners and independent entrepreneurs. Africa was an essential part of the Indian Ocean trading space. On the East Coast, Swahili-speaking cities engaged actively in commerce, exchanging things like ivory, rhinoceros horns, tortoise shells, and dried coconut. They were also amongst the first converters to Islam outside the Arabian Peninsula. On the West Coast, commercial activities and exchanging goods, ideas, information, and people were also important and contributed to the consolidation of the Afro-Eurasian trading space. On that side of the continent, there was trading of gold, slaves with non-racial connotation attached, and salt. The commercial activity there was so intense that big empires formed. The most important of all was the Mali Empire, led by the wealthiest person in the history of the world, Mansa Musa. This is all we have for this micro lecture. If you need to contact me or have any questions, write me an email or stop by my virtual office hours on Zoom. Thank you.